हेलो माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, आई एम सुजॉय एंड टुडे आई विल टेल यू 15 प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ डिटरमिनेंट्स इन वेरी इजी लैंग्वेज। बट नॉट ओनली दैट, आई विल ऑल्सो प्रूव देम ऑन कैसियो एफएक्स एंड ऑन ईएस साइंटिफिक कैलकुलेटर। दिस वीडियो विल बी ऑफ टू पार्ट्स। इन फर्स्ट पार्ट आई विल टेल एंड प्रूव सम प्रॉपर्टीज एंड रिमेनिंग आई विल टेल एंड प्रूव इन सेकेंड पार्ट। आवर फर्स्ट प्रॉपर्टी, डिटरमिनेंट इज अ रियल नंबर associated with every square matrix represented by det of A or mod of A, where A is a square matrix. Property number 2, determinant is a real number, it's not a matrix. Determinant can be negative or positive number. Property number 3, determinant exists only for square matrices such as 2 into 2 or 3 cross 3, 4 cross 4, etc. Square matrix means where number of rows and number of columns are same. Fourth property, the value of a determinant of a matrix remains unaltered or unchanged by changing its rows into columns and columns into rows. The process of interchanging rows into columns and columns into rows are called transpose of a matrix. We can easily transpose a matrix on this calculator. So first, let me show you matrix A, which is 10, 5, 3, 3, 6, 9, and 7, 3, 2. This is called row 1, this is row 2, and this is row 3. Similarly, this is called column 1, this is column 2, and column 3. So these are 3 cross 3 matrix with 3 rows and 3 columns. So let's transpose it. Option 8 for transpose. So transpose of matrix A is this matrix. Well, rows are written as columns 10, 5, 3, 3, 6, 9 and 7, 3, 2. So let's find out the determinant of the original matrix A, which is 36, and our transpose matrix is stored in 6 matans. So let's find out the determinant of the transpose matrix, which is also 36. So this property is proved. Fifth property, the value of a determinant remains unaltered if each element of a row or a column is increased or decreased by the same multiple of the corresponding element of another row or column. So that means if we subtract sum of row 2 and row 3 from row 1, the value of determinant will unchanged. Similarly, the property applies for columns also, for any row or any column. So let me show you with the row only. So the first value in row 1 is 10, and summation of values in row 2 and row 3 is 3 plus 7 is 10. So 10 minus 10 equals to 0. Next, this is 6 and 3, that is 9. So 5 minus 9 is minus 4. And this is 9 and this is 2. So 9 plus 2 is 11, and this is 3. So 3 minus 11 is minus 8. So we have got our new matrix with 0, minus 4 and minus 8 in row 1. So it should give us the same determinant value as it was in matrix A. Let's try it. So the determinant was 36 and now it's also 36. So this property is verified. Our sixth property, if two adjacent rows or columns of a determinant are interchanged, the numerical value of the determinant remains the same, but its sign is changed. That means if we interchange row 1 with row 2, the value of determinant will remain unchanged. The property applies for the columns also. That means if we write all the values in row 1 in row 2 and all the values in row 2 in row 1, the determinant will remain unchanged. So let me try it. So first writing row 2 values in row 1 and row 1 values in row 2. So row 2 and row 1 are interchanged. The determinant will remain same, but its sign will be changed. So determinant numerical value is same, that is 36, but the sign is changed, that is minus 36. Next we will discuss about the property of zeros. So our seventh property, if two rows or columns of a matrix is identical, the value of its determinant is zero. So here we have two identical rows. Row 1 is 10, 5, 3, also row 2 is 10, 5, 3. So determinant should be equal to 0. It's 0. So if two rows or columns of a matrix is identical, the value of its determinant is 0. So our second property of zeros, our eighth property. If determinant of a matrix is 0, the matrix is not invertible. That means we can't find out inverse of that matrix. So let's find out determinant of our matrix C, that is equal to 0. That means we can't find out inverse of matrix C, no matter by which process we try to find out the inverse. So matrix C inverse, let's press equals to, we get a math error. I have another video called Properties of Matrices. There I described if the determinant is equal to 0, why we can't find out the inverse. The reason is, if this value is 0 and this is adjoint A value, so we can't divide any real number by 0. That is why if this value is 0 or determinant value is 0, we can't find out the inverse value. Property number 9, if matrix A is not invertible, then matrix AB is also not invertible. That means if matrix A is not invertible, then product of matrix A and B is also not invertible. So determinant for matrix A was 0. That means matrix A is not invertible. So matrix A into B will not be invertible also. So matrix A into B is this, which is stored into matrix answer. So let's try to find out inverse of it. We will get a math error. That means it is not invertible. So this property is proved. Tenth property, if matrix A has a row or column of all zeros, then determinant of matrix A is equal to 0. So we have a matrix A with column 2 with all 0 numbers. So the determinant of matrix A will be 0. Let's give it a try. Yeah, it's 0. So this was the end of the part 1 of this video. In part 2, I will discuss rest of the properties of determinants. So how was the video? Let me know in the comments below. If you want more videos like this, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. By subscribing, you can stay connected with me. Just when I upload my next video, you will get an email if you subscribe. And please share this video among your friends and family, because knowledge is meant to be shared. I just don't make videos, I try to deliver some knowledge to my viewers. You can watch my other numerical method videos. There are more than 30 videos in numerical methods playlist covering all the syllabus of colleges and universities. The link is given in the video description below. So thanks for watching, see you in my next video, and till then, stay connected by subscribing.